Okay, so I'm going to take a slightly different tact. I already explained to you my disclosures. This is Michael Montz. He's a formidable opponent, also known as the Robot Man. And what I want to talk about to begin with is really a little bit about what's happening in medicine today and what are the forces that really at work that every one of us deals with day to day. We have the demographic environment, and that is pretty clear cut, that we're all in good shape and that the need for joint replacement going forward, it continues to grow tremendously. Currently, over 1 million hip and knee replacements are done in the United States, and the projections are this will continue to increase exponentially. This is the growth of total knee replacement in Sweden, growing tremendously. The other effect that we have to deal with is the so-called economic environment, the value effect. We don't talk about results anymore, we talk about value. And value is a big buzzword. And value really has to do with costs and what the return is in terms of what you do, innovation particularly. This is the GNP of the United States in terms of healthcare costs. 16 to 90% of our GNP is healthcare costs. If you look at it compared to every other developed country in the United States, there is the United States, a significant outlier, when we talk about outliers, compared to every other developed country. And my point going forward is that these costs are not sustainable. And day to day we live with continued pressures in terms of the economic expenses that healthcare costs in this country. So fact number one is that hip and knee implants demonstrate, as has been pointed out earlier today, 90-95% success rate at 15 to 20 years. So that's a given. And if we look at our results going forward, this is a Swedish registry, and we continue to get better. That's a point I made earlier, and that's a point that has been validated in many registries. The purple on the bottom are the most recent knee replacements being done and the lesser failure rates. And the other thing, another fact that is very obvious is that there's a maturation of implant technology. So yes, there are little tweaks here or there, but if you look at the implants today across the board, they look pretty much the same. And all of them, as been reported earlier this morning, have really outstanding results. So fact number two is that new technology in joint replacement is expensive, and that's going to drive the system going forward. And that drives everything in healthcare, and that will drive the costs and what we do going forward. So this is an interesting comment by a health economist. We need to evaluate the comparative effectiveness of emerging and existing technology and price the new in a way that reflects their incremental value. So if you're going to do something that's new, you've got to demonstrate that, in fact, it is better and has, therefore, value. So let's talk about robotic surgery in the context of a new technology and the environment that I've just outlined for you. This is an interesting study done, published in the New England Journal of Medicine. So these authors looked at 20 different types of surgery across the board, urology, cardiac, orthopedics. And what they found was those surgeries in which the robot technology was used, the variable cost was greater by $3,200. The overall cost of robotic substitution for conventional techniques was $2.5 billion across the surgical arena. And the conclusion of this paper was that observational evidence fails to show long-term outcomes of robotic-assisted surgery are superior to those of conventional surgery. So this is across the board, but in orthopedic surgery, we have to demonstrate that this technology, because it is more expensive, is better and our outcomes are better. So here's what we have available. The original one, the Mako system, is available. You got to do a CT scan with the Mako. That's $1,000 or whatever. Significant expense. That's radiation to the patient. And now the Zimmer Biomet company has the X-ray-based ROSA system. So if you look at the cost of robotic surgery, just to lay it out, the robot costs anywhere between $850,000 and $1.3 million. The maintenance costs for these robots, and we have three or four at the hospital, our HSS, the maintenance cost is $150,000, and you got to do the CT scan. And not to mention that you need a technician, usually in the room, when you do robotic surgery. So there's a real cost there. Now, there are some advantages, and I think Michael pointed them out very well. The coronal and probably rotational alignment is somewhat better, and that's been documented in robotic studies. But again, we're talking a degree or two. This is a paper by Abdel from the Mayo Group. And this is the most recent iteration of their paper, looking at alignment and overall results. And so the conclusion of this new 20-year follow-up patient was at 20 years, we once again did not find that neutral alignment provided better implant survivorship than found in the outlier group. So my point is that you can get excellent long-term results with a degree or two or 3 degrees, where you're not perfectly in neutral alignment. So that's a case against perhaps the use of the robot where, in fact, that alignment may be better. So these are just a couple of papers. There's not a lot of literature, because I went to the literature when I presented this last year as well as this year. There's not a lot of papers out there. Maybe there will be going forward. This is a paper, I think this is a good paper. This is a paper out of Korea. This is 11-year follow-up of two cohorts of patients, robotic versus conventional. And you can see here that the survivorship at 11 years was the same. And the alignment was a little bit better in the robotic system, as I've mentioned. This is another paper recently presented at the Academy, 5,000 total knee replacements, 1,200 were robotic, 3,000 were conventional. The cost differential, greater in the robotic group, as you would expect. Operating time, greater, also cost, than in the conventional group. Length of stay, a little bit less in the robotic system, but they were a younger, fitter, less obese population, and no functional difference in the two groups. A very, very large series of patients. So what are the disadvantages of the robotic system as I see it? I think the disadvantages are, one, cost, as I've outlined to you. Two, CTs are expensive and increase radiation to our patients if you use that. Three, aside from the little dance that we do, they're cumbersome. You bring a robot into the operating room, it takes room, and I'm concerned that you may contaminate the operative field by having this machine in and out and moving about. So I think there's potential risk there. We've not documented that, but I have a concern about that. I think it does increase OR time. Most people have documented that, and it is more fiddling and more surgeon stress, I think, when you do it. So in summary, I think conventional total knee replacement got some real advantages. Highly accurate, as I mentioned earlier today, outstanding long-term outcomes, less expensive, less hassle, less radiation. Thank you.